guys, Merry Christmas. So today is actually Christmas Day. This might seem random to be filming and uploading this or like on Christmas Day the next day after, but we only have a pretty small family, so I don't do anything too crazy for Christmas. So my mum's just gone to have a sleep because she's going to work shortly. So yeah, I just didn't really have anything better to do, to be honest, than start filming. So I know a lot of people, I've seen YouTubers put disclaimers in front of these videos, but to me, I'm not like obviously trying to brag or anything about what I've got, like it's nothing like that, but I'm like really nosy and I like seeing what other people got for Christmas. So I thought you guys might want to see what I've got for Christmas. So let's just jump into what I got for Christmas this year. So I'll just start off with what my friend Tarina got me. You might have seen her in a previous video before, but we did Christmas this year for each other. So we did our present exchange this morning after we went to the gym. So I will just show you what she got me. Yeah, we don't usually get each other anything like big presents for Christmas or anything, but she's packaged this in this really nice cardboardy brown something sort of paper bag, but I think it's really pretty, to be honest. Now I've obviously already opened it, so the wrapping paper's torn up and gone, and I'll just jump straight into this first thing. She got me two things. Set, I don't know if it's supposed to be a travel set or just like a holiday, I'd say it's just a holiday Christmas gift set, but it just looks like that. Really nice packaging. It comes with, I think that is a, yeah, a crayon eyeliner, a Kohl eyeliner in that one. The Grandiose mascara, which I'm actually wearing today, and I really enjoy it so far. This is the first time I've used it. I think I've heard someone, maybe Tati, talking about it before, saying that it was really good, so very excited to keep wearing that one. A little mini lip gloss and a red nail polish, which I'll try and get out and show you guys. But I haven't used anything for N. Lancome before, so I'm really excited to try this stuff out. The nail polish just looks like that. It's just a really nice red color. Excited to wear that one because I don't really have any nail polish that's good left. This is the pink, I think it's just a lip gloss, not a lip stain or something, which is just a really nice bright Barbie sort of color pink. I'll swatch on the back of my hand here. I actually haven't even looked at it myself yet, so it's just a nice lip gloss. Just looks like that, nice and shiny and glossy. It doesn't feel too sticky either, which I think will be good. And then the Lancome eyeliner, which is just, oh, that looks really nice. Which is just a nice pencil liner. I don't really use pencil liners too often, but it's always handy to have one of those on hand. So it just looks like that. And the mascara bottle that this comes in is actually really pretty. Like, it's got like sort of a flower encased in the top of the tube. Like a little black flower, which I think is really cool. And then yeah, just Lancome Grandiose mascara. Really interesting bottle as well. The brush is like heaps curvy. You've got to like, I don't know if you'll be able to say this properly, but when you like twist it out, you've got to like get it on an angle because look at that brush, man, that's nuts. So the bristles just look like that. I don't think I have a brush that looks like this with these bristles, but yeah, it's really good. It's really nice in a dark black mascara, so that's awesome. Really loving that one so far. Then so the other thing she got me, I've already ruined the pretty bow that it came in, but it was pretty much a dead giveaway when you smelt what this is, which I'm sure most of you will guess what it is by now, but it just comes in this really pretty box. I'm going to keep this box, I don't know what I'm going to use it for, but it's really, really pretty. I like it. So it just looks like that. I'm going to take the bow off it. I wonder what it's going to be. What is it? 30 now. I don't know why I want to wear this, but I actually really want to wear this. Oh, by the way, do you like my tree? It's my tree hat. I got it from, I think, David Jones or Maya. Been wearing it to work lately because people think it's hilarious, but I think it's really cool. So I'm just going to wear my ribbon now as a scarf for a minute. Then ta-da! Just looks like that inside. It is obviously a Lush gift set, if you can see. Plenty of packing peanuts in here. Oh, goody. So I'll just tell you what ones are in here. It is so white. I haven't tried this one before, so that one should be good. It's just got a little leafy thing on there. I don't know what that's about, but whatever. And then I've got this nice blue one. Oops, I'm going to drop it. Then it's got this blue one, which I think is Shoot for the Stars. Yep. chip this up. I think I've had this one once before, but I can't remember what it's like. So really excited to give that one a go. It's just got nice stars on it. We have this one, which I have had before, which smells awesome. I'm really excited to use this one, which just looks like that. Really nice, really pretty, super good smelling. Not that all Lush products aren't really nice to smell. And this one is actually one of my favorite bath bombs ever. It's the little present one. I forget what it's called, like box something, Golden Wonder. It's called Golden Wonder. Sorry, this isn't gonna, it's blacking out because of what I'm wearing. And then, yeah, it just looks like that. It's a nice present. Then it's got like heaps of multicolors on the inside of it. Really random, but this one came without wrapping. I don't know why, what that's about. So unless they ran out of packaging, I don't know about. But yeah, this smells so good. I can't stop smelling it. Every room I leave this in, it's just smelling so good. I'm really excited to get some bath action going on. I'm probably going to have one tonight now that I've got all these goodies to get some use out of. So thank you very much, Tarina, for those gifts. That's really awesome. Thank you so much. So other than Tarina and my mom, there's not actually anyone else that I really do gift giving with. Me and Alyssa made an agreement not to do presents this year. We usually do presents for each other, but because we're going to America in like 2 weeks, pretty much straight after Christmas, we just wanted to save whatever money that we could have that we would usually spend on presents for each other, just to save and put towards America. So me and her aren't doing Christmas presents this year, but that's fine. Like, obviously no big deal. And then, so me and my friends, Scott and Justin, we do, I think we've done Christmas 2 or maybe 3 years in a row now. I think this might be the 3rd year in a row. I can't remember now. But yeah, we do Christmas presents for each other as well. So I'm actually going to see them tomorrow now. So this is sort of going to be like a little bit of a chop of footage. Like, I'm going to insert it now, like after I finish talking, blabbing on, of course. I won't stop rambling ever. So I'm going to insert the footage of what they got me after this, but it's just going to be more of a vlog style, not a sit down, because I have a lot of things to do tomorrow and I'm probably not going to have time to get out my studio lights and set it up, but I'm still going to insert it here so that you guys can see what I got from them. Other than that, the only other person that I did gifts with this year was my mum. Hey guys, so it's the next day, it's Boxing Day. I just had my lovely dinner with Justin and Scott. Don't mind my face, it's a little bit questionable at the moment. I'm just sitting down here like doing this sort of like vlog style to show you what I got from the boys, just because I don't want to get all my equipment set up and everything. So sorry if this looks a bit funny compared to the other shot. So what they got me, I'll just show you this first thing, is this magnetic mount for your phone that goes in the car. So it's like a magnet that sits on your air vent, and then this part suctions to the back of your phone, which I will show you, because I put the thing on it and it just suctions the back of your phone so that you don't have to like have it sitting anywhere, and you can just have it sitting upright on your vent so you can like see if someone messages you or calls you, who's ringing, etc. So I was really excited to get that one. That's awesome. And then I'll show you this one. They got me this thing, a self-stirring mug. So it looks like that, and then it's got a button on the side, you put batteries in it, and then it mixes itself. So like if you've got something to drink. And it's also like a travel one, so you can take it in the car, because it's got that little plastic lid with the zipper, which is really good. Which I think is going to be pretty funny to try and use. And then the next thing that they got me, it's very generous of them, is this Pandora bag with 3 charms. I've already got them in my bracelet, so I'll show you what they are. So I got this nice blue one. It's not really showing up that true to colour. It's more of a vibrant, like deep blue in person. That blue one in the middle, and then the 2 infinity ones on the side with the little gems in it. The 2 silver ones, it's trying to focus on the other ones, but I wanted to focus on these ones. Yes, I got those 2 ones. All these other charms and the bracelet they got me for my 21st as well. So that's very nice. These ones, nice, super pretty ones to add to my collection. Sorry if this keeps going in and out. I don't know why it's not trying to focus on that.
Yeah, so I'm just going to get stuck into what I got from my mum. Most of the time, I usually just go shopping with her, or I pick out what I want just so that, well, like, you know, she tells me what she wants, I tell her what I want, just so that we like get each other what we want, something that we're going to use, something that's useful, something that we need, etc, etc. But yeah, I'll just jump straight into what she got me. She's very generous this year. She got me way too many things, but I'm just going to jump straight into what she got me. This is going to be in no particular order. I'm literally, all my stuff's just sitting behind me here, like, look how messy that is. That's why I've got my big chair blocking out all of the mess, except you can sort of see it on the side there, whoops. But yeah, I'm just going to show you what she got me. So first thing I'm grabbing is the Lady Million perfume by, I think his name's Paco Rabanne. I don't know how to pronounce it because I ain't French or wherever he's from. And this perfume I've been wearing for probably about 3 years now, pretty much as soon as it came out, which is just a really nice really classy scent. I don't know, I'm not gonna even bother describing how it smells, but yeah, it's just in a really pretty bottle too. It's really nice smelling, so I'm very happy to get stocked up on another one of those, because I actually ran out, I think 2 weeks ago now, I ran out of this one, so very happy to have another one of those ones, so thank you, Mum. Then the next thing that I've got here is the next season of my absolute favourite TV show at the moment. I'm pretty sure this is my favourite still at the moment, but it is Suits Season 6 Part 1. Sorry if you're getting reflections from my ring light, but that's just something we're going to deal with now. But I haven't seen any of Season 6. It came out ages ago on TV, but I can't get TV in my room properly. I don't have like the American Netflix because we obviously live here in Australia, so I can't watch this as it's aired. A lot of times we have to wait ages for series to come out, so I've been waiting for this for like 6 something months now, but I haven't opened it yet. I will probably get straight stuck into this tonight after I use a bath bomb and have a bath. Thank you, Trina. So yeah, really happy to have that one. So the next thing I'm going to show is actually really random, but extremely useful for me because this is probably going to be too TMI, but whatever. Because I have to wear steel cap boots to work and like really heavy duty socks, my skin, sorry, don't mind me, my skin on my heels sometimes gets like really like chapped and gross and like it peels up all the time and it's really uneven to walk on and it sometimes it actually starts getting really painful. So she got me this little foot, I don't know if it's, you don't even see anything on this, but that's the packaging that came in. I ripped into it because I used it last night just to give it a test out. It's just, I think it's by the brand Shoal. And it's just this like foot skin scrubber thing to get rid of all of like your calluses and like just dead skin and stuff. And then this is gonna be like really crazy, but that all over the wherever you've got dead skin or like if I don't know what else you would use it for, but yeah, that's just gonna really help with the soles of my foot. I used it last night and it's already smoothed out my feet so much, and I'm so excited to keep using that. I think I'm gonna get heaps of use out of this one. So the next thing I'm going to show you that she got me, I actually have to unfold because I wore them last night. It is just these really, oh, is that the wrong way again? Just these really cute pajama set from Kmart with, I think, I've never watched Looney Tunes, I think it's like Tweety Bird and whatever the mouse is called, I don't remember. And it says Putty Tat on the front there. And then it's just a t-shirt. And then it's got the matching short bottoms to go with them. So we're in summer now, we're all pretty much wearing shorts in pajamas, so it just comes with the same matching set of pajama pants. These are super comfortable as well because I slept in them last night, so really happy about those ones. So the next two things I'll show you I actually picked out, and that was what I asked for very kindly for my Christmas presents this year, just so that it could help me with my YouTube videos and everything. And I know if anyone actually reads my description bar, I've been going on about my microphone and my ring light for God knows how long in the last, like, I think probably 10 videos that I've uploaded. I'm like, yeah, it's so much better quality coming to you soon. Is it really, Shen? Is it really? You decide. Haha, John Cocky and fam. Lol. Anyway, I'm just gonna get crazy from now on now that I've actually got proper setup. So my camera is actually just balancing on top of the ring light that I got because I can't figure out how to get my tripod to sit correctly in front or behind of my ring light, so I'm gonna have to look more into that to see if I can get it to work properly. But yes, the first thing I'll insert a just like a light over here because I can't film it with my ring light and my camera set up as it is now. But yeah, so first thing I got is my ring light. We ordered all these off eBay. I searched for I think like 2 weeks of a couple of YouTubers just to see which ring lights were the best, what ones they were using, which ones I like the quality of. If I can find the link for the particular ones I got, I'll insert them in the description box below, but don't hold me to that because they might not have them anymore, I don't know. But yeah, so I'm really happy to have my ring light. I'm very, very excited. Not even just for videos, but for photos, especially when like it's special effects time and I get to do like pretty crazy makeup again. I'm really excited for that. And then the other thing I got was my microphone. I just got the Blue Ice Snowball microphone. That was the one that Shanexo used. That's where I looked up because I like the way that she does her voiceovers. So I sussed out what microphone she was using and it said that she was using a Snowball one. So that was the first one that I found. I'll insert a video clip here of what it looks like out. But yeah, it's just pretty standard. I'm assuming it's nothing special. I don't know anything about microphones. But yeah, so I just got those ones as well. That's for the two things that were my main gift, which I was very excited about. So the next few things, I've got quite a few things now, are the rest of the stuff that I picked out when we went down to IMATS, because I dragged my mum down to IMATS this year. Thank you very much, mum, for joining me, because I couldn't get anyone to come with me and I don't want to go by myself. So I dragged her down to IMATS, and then I paid for some of the stuff myself, and then some of the stuff mum said that she would... And yeah, the rest of the stuff mum said that she would pay for and put aside for my Christmas present. So some of this stuff, I've already taken the other parts of it out. But yeah, I'll just show you what the rest of the stuff that I picked out was. I'm very excited to start using all this stuff. The first thing I got, like, came with one of the sets that I got from Real Techniques. I'm just going to start with all the brushes that I got. And then it's just like this mirror travel holder case thing. I don't know what I'm going to use that for, but it just came with, like, a free gift with all the stuff that we got. So I have that one. And then the next... brushes, I've got two sets and two individual brushes that are all from Real Techniques. The first one I've got, sorry, this is going to focus that well, it's just small kabuki face brush. If I can, I'll try and insert individual pictures like clearer to the side or something, but yeah. Then the next one I got is a powder brush. I don't know if these have brush names or like numbers or whatever, but I just got the powder brush, which just looks like that, really nice. The other brushes that I've started using that I bought myself, I'm really liking from Real Techniques, so I think I'm going to really enjoy these. The next one I got was just this, is eyeshadow brush set thingamajigger. I haven't used any of the Real Techniques eye brushes yet, so I'm excited that I have those ones. And the next one is just called a Travel Essentials, which has another one of those casings inside it, but I don't know what I'm going to use them for. And then I think just got a concealer brush, an eyeshadow brush, and a just fluffy face brush, which they just look like that. So I'm really excited to have those ones in my collection, and I'll let you guys know how they work for me. So those are those. Oopsie, shit. Fuck. And so the next two things that I picked up were these two 12 shadow Morphe palettes, just in these little boxes here. This, the shadow palette that I wanted from Morphe was the 35OM, like that really popular orangey brown matte shades one, was all sold out by the time that we got to the front of the line because it took forever. So I just ended up picking out some random ones. The first one I got was this really colourful looking, it's got this plastic thing on the front of it, so you might be able to show the shadows a little bit better there. Which this one is called the 12P palette. I don't know what the P stands for, if it's like, I don't know, pigment or something, I don't know. But yeah, I just really wanted some nice, bright, vibrant colours for when I do makeup looks. If I need a proper colour for anything, I'll insert some swatches to the side of what those ones look like. And then the next one I got also came in this little small box thing. Plastic insert just fell out. And this one is called the 12S, which I'm assuming is 12 shimmers, which I think the 35O shimmer palette that I've already got has these shades in it, but I don't know. So I'm going to have to compare if they do, and if they do, I might have to give this one away. I don't know, but I think some of them are quite different. So nonetheless, I'm still happy to have those ones. These Morphe shadows are really pigmented, as you'll see in the swatches to the side, but these ones are all just so shimmery, so pretty. The last like makeup product I got was the original RCMA No Colour Powder, the one that was going around on YouTube, Instagram, every freaking where on the planet the last couple of months or so. I think Kathleen's Light started this trend of this one, but yeah, I'm going to see how that is for setting underneath the eyes. A lot of people say that it doesn't have flashback, but I'm really scared because it's like extremely white powder, like it's so white. So hopefully it's good, because I think this one... Yeah, I only paid $20 for this one, so if it works, it's very cheap, and I will definitely be using it as a staple if it's good, but yeah, so we have that one. And so the next thing I got is pretty much all the same thing, it's a bit ridiculous, it's just this random bag full of eyelashes. So we just got a bag from Model Rock Lashes. I heard really good things about them, so they had a big massive stand there of Model Rock Lashes. It was like, I think it was something crazy, like by 20 or 30 pairs or something for $30 or some deal like that, which has worked out to be really good. So taking these out, I have these ones are all the same. I have 4 pairs of kit, I don't know what that means, I'm assuming just Demi Wispies. I have 4 pairs of these ones, which I think they just look really nice. Okay, so these, all of the next ones are completely different name numbers. So I got these ones in the number 43. These ones in 217. These ones in 218, which are really dramatic. Like they fan out, like going from, oh, don't mind that, that's my lipstick. Going from small to big fan out at the edge. The next ones are in the number 200, which look like that. I think these ones are like a nice natural sort of semi-natural looking eyelash. The next one is in 233, which just look like that. And then the last one, I don't know what this means, but it says 747M. I don't know what the M stands for, so I apologize for that, but they just look like that. They all pretty much look exactly the same to me, but anyway, nonetheless, we picked up all of those. And also, again, still from Model Rock Lashes. I think these are like their, I don't know, premium lashes, these next ones, because they come in like these fancier boxes. But yeah, so I don't know why these ones are in different boxes. I don't know what the difference is between them. But these ones are called Central Park. I don't know if you can really see them that well, but they just look like that. The next ones are London Girl, which look like that. So you know, I'm seeing the plastic's reflecting really bad, but yeah, they just look. Set I got is in Bardot Bombshell, which I think these ones are going to be my favourite. Not that you can see anything because of my ring light, but yeah, I think those ones look really nice. And then I completely forgot that I picked this out, but I was hearing someone going on about the Model Rock lash glue. I forget, maybe it was Jazz Makeup by Jazz, I'm not sure. But this one is just a clear white latex free waterproof eyelash adhesive brush on applicator. At the moment, I'm just using the Ardell Brush-On Lash Adhesive. Lash Adhesive. Yes, Jen, that's exactly how you say that. Oh, yeah. So, whatever that one's called, because I'm not even going to try it again. So, I just picked up this one just to test it out, see what this one's like. So, these are, the next three things are from Inglot. I've never owned anything from them before until we went to IMATS. So, these are Pure Pigment Eyeshadows, just in little single individual things. This one is in the number 32. They don't have names, but yes, it just looks like that. It's a, I would say like a dark iridescent sort of blue color, which you'll see better in the swatches anyway, but I don't know why I just took the box off that. Which yeah, so I was really happy about that one. And then this next one, I'm so excited to try on my lid or my face, wherever I want to put it, because when I swatched it, this came out completely different to what it looks like in the actual container, but it just looks so pretty. I'm really excited to try this one. This one's in the shade 113. I'm just going to even try to show you now. It looks nothing like what it does in a swatch, but either way, it's just so pretty. The last thing I got from Inglot is called a Body Sparkler. I've never had or heard of anything like this before, so I don't know what I'm actually supposed to do with this yet, but it looks like a really nice highlighter color, even if I don't use it on my body. So hey, there is no rules to makeup, right? And then it is in the number 53, and it's just this really small cute little container with a, it's more of a pink white sort of iridescent shimmery shade, which you'll see in the overlay. And this next thing I actually had a little bit of a drama with when I was trying to film my overlays and my close-ups of these, because this is I'm just going to tell you what happened. This is the Lit Cosmetics glitter in the shade Vixen, which just looks like this. They're in a really nice, like, pretty square container. The packaging's really cute. So I'm cursed. This eyeshadow, I swear to God. I was going to edit it out, but like, I'm going to insert what happened with this shadow when I was at the front trying to film my insert for this, but I swear it's cursed. But it's just this really nice, I don't even know why I'm bothering this because you're going to see it in the thing anyway, but it's just this really pretty sparkly red glitter, which I'm excited to use. If I had more time, I would have tried to use it on my eyes now because it's red and it's Christmas, but I ran out of time. And yeah, I'm still really excited to use that one. I might wear it for New Year's Eve, I haven't decided yet. And the next thing I have got, I'm super, super excited about. I don't know which, if I had to pick like a favorite present, I think this might be it, because I've been wanting this for so long. So I'll just give you a quick backstory. Like, I'm absolutely hopeless at curling my hair with anything. Like, I've tried GHD curls before, I've tried barrel curls, I used to have a triple barrel, didn't work, couldn't do it. I've had numerous like clip-on clamp things, and yeah, I just have no idea what I'm doing, so I threw them all out years ago because I just gave up. And every now and again I'll try again with my GHD because I'm like, I see people doing it in like 2 seconds and their curls look amazing, but for whatever reason I can't do it. So there's this really, really nice curling set that I've been looking at for ages, and I spoke about it once to Mum and she very, very generously picked it up for me. It is the Curling Stick by Muck, which I've heard is a very good brand. I don't know if MUK stands for anything or if it's pronounced Muck or MUK, but who knows. So I'm starting to take this thing off. Oh, I'm just so excited. I'm sure this is going to make me trying to curl my hair so much easier. I'm so excited. I can't even get into it. I'm so excited. So on the inside, it's got the actual wand and then two change out little wands that you can use for it. So that looks really like that. I'm going to try and, maybe I'll curl my hair tomorrow, I don't know. If I get time, I'm going to try and do it tomorrow after work. And then she also got me this travel and storage pouch to go with it. So if I want to take this traveling, I can put all of the attachments and the actual wand itself in here, so I don't have to have it loose just hanging around, which is really good because if I can get this to work and it looks good, I'm going to take it to America with me because I'm very excited. Buttered. And then, which is also really handy, that travel thing, because she bought me another separate attachment that goes onto it. This one is the 32mm barrel with clip. So it's one of those ones that has the little clip thing, so you don't have to like hold your hand over it. You just pop your hair in there and it clamps down. So very excited to try those out. We are finally on to the last thing, which is probably going to be like extremely hard for me to show you in this because it is massive. Like, this is insane. I didn't even know they did these sort of gift set things, but I'm sure you have all heard of Glasshouse candles and the whole Glasshouse brand and the traditional Taha smell, like the vanilla caramel smell. Look at this. Oh my god. Oh my god. Look, it's in this like really nice, I don't know what sort of bowl this would be used for. I have a fruit bowl that's like extremely similar to this, so I might have two fruit bowls in there, who knows. But it just comes in this really pretty gold bowl sort of thing, and then it's got, okay, this has this nice body soap down there, and then a hand cream is that one there, and then of course the candle, which is out here. They've put it on the outside there. And then on the side here, we have a hand cream, which I have been meaning to get a hand cream for ages, so I'm really excited to have that. And then we also have the reed diffuser, which is amazing. I've had it once before, and I've had, I think it's called, I don't remember, whatever the black one was called. It was like a black stem. I think it starts with an M, but I completely forgot what it's called. But yeah, their reed diffusers are so amazing. Like, they're almost just as good as the candles. Like, they are so amazing. Oh my god, the plastic almost just melted on my ring light then. Oh my god, that's dangerous. So yeah, look how amazing that is. I didn't even know they did gift sets of this stuff. Like, that is so cool. I'm so happy about that. And between that and the Lush, like, this room just smells amazing right now. I can't even get over it. But yes, that is what I got for Christmas, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching. I'm going to probably go on a rampage over the next couple of days and stalk out all my favorite YouTubers and see what they got for Christmas, because I don't know why, but I'm really interested in what other people got for Christmas. I just find it super interesting. Like, I like to see like different gift sets that different companies and brands have, what sort of, like, it's an easy way to find out like what new stuff is out, and I don't know, I just really, yeah, I just really enjoy watching what everyone got. So obviously, as I said before at the start of this video, I'm not bragging or anything. I'm just wanted to show you guys what I got because I think some of these gifts are like really amazing, really cool, different sort of gift sets and just new products that I haven't used before. So I'm really excited to give those a go and see how I get on with them. I hope you guys had the best Christmas. I hope you got spoiled. I hope you got all the things that you wanted. I hope you got to spend a lot of good time with all your family, with your friends, and just overall hope you had a great Christmas. I don't even think the sales, I have to work, so no sales for me, but anyway, I'm trying to save my money, so it doesn't really matter. But yeah, hopefully this video will go up on Boxing Day, which is tomorrow. Fingers crossed, because I have really ridiculously slow internet. Usually takes me like 3 days to upload one video, so who knows. But I still hope you guys enjoy watching this video, even if it doesn't go up on the 25th or the 26th. So yes, I'm gonna stop rambling now because I'm sure you're sick of hearing me and my voice by now. If anyone's interested in the lip color I'm wearing, it is a Too Faced Melted Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade, where is it? I can't find the hell is shade. It's Happening, I think that's what it's called. In the shade It's Happening, which is just a nice like fuchsia pink color, which I've never really worn before, but I think it looks nice. It doesn't look too bad with my, I think it really like contrasts between my hat and my lips. So I think that looks really pretty. But yeah, anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you had a great Christmas, as I just said before, like 50 times. But anyway, goodbye.